What is the biggest thing that you're struggling with?
I am sick, I don't know where to go. Remorse is something that you cannot repair.
Yeah.
Now you can't do anything like that.
How old are you?
79.
What does it feel like to be 79?
To be 79 when you don't have a personal doctor in this city or province is catastrophic, because you start being so worried about something that could happen that you get sick even without having any reasons to be sick.
What is the biggest thing that you're struggling with right now?
Uncertainty about, if I am sick, I don't know where to go. I have to go to the emergency or hospital. You wait maybe 10, 12 hours. Also, we are slowly losing our memory, and I realize that, and this worries me.
How old do you feel? Do you feel 79?
Physically, I feel younger, but mentally, I feel older.
Oh, interesting. How come mentally you feel older? Because of the memory?
Because of this fear of the future. The future is short, it's fast.
Right.
And soon it's going to be too much.
Right. If you could go back and relive any age that you've previously been, is there one in particular you would pick and why?
Between 35 and 45. Because you already know exactly what you can do and what you cannot do and what you should not do. And you behave accordingly. You are still very vigorous.
Do you have an example of something that we shouldn't do?
Never do anything that might cause remorse in your mind afterwards, because remorse is something that you cannot repair, because it's a result of having offended without reason someone, or being hurt someone, or etc. So avoid anything that could cause remorse eventually.
Is there something that you did that you feel remorseful about?
We all have done something, but once you have done it once, you make sure you don't do it again.
Is there something that when we're younger, we tend to put a lot of priority on, but when we get older, we realize isn't actually that important?
When I was young, it's very different from what is being young now. We had rules, we were not spoiled, and being spoiled, it's very destructive.
You brought up properly, right?
Yes, that's right.
That's it. To appreciate everything.
Yes, that's
brought
right.
Up to appreciate everything. What's the problem now?
No problem.
No problem now?
Well, we have tons of problems. That's not the issue. The issue is, we're brought up in a different way.
Right.
My mother, she told me, turn a cheek. If someone comes at you or yells at you or insults you, look the other way. Bend your back, you'll have a fight.
Yes.
What for? It's not worth it.
But if you ignore them, they're even more offended. Eventually, they will calumniate you, you know?
Yeah. How old are you? Tell us the truth.
72.
What does it feel like to be 72?
It doesn't feel any different from being 18.
Really?
Here.
Okay.
Physically, your body changes and everything. But being 72, it's no different. This place, Montreal, was the Paris of North America. Do you remember?
I'm not here because I'm European. So
where are you from?
I was born in Italy, raised in France.
Well, I love my favorite country in the world is Italy. You lived in two of the most fashionable places in the world, and I bet you dressed magnificent.
Well, I'm in Italy. I am in my country house. It was built in 1722.
Really?
And I have a huge garden, and I'm in the garden from the first minute, the light of the morning and the last of the day. And I'm very happy in the nature, because nature never disappoints you.
Well, we lost a lot of nature with these buildings.
When you look at the 20-somethings of today, what do you think of them?
My kids are 25 and 27. I think they're amazing. So much smarter than we were. They don't have any hatred in them. I brought them up, everybody is the same.
What do you think of social media?
I think social media is great, because my kids have friends everywhere in the world. But bad part is too many people try to brainwash people. And that's the biggest problem with social media, in my opinion.
And a pessimist and an optimist.
What would you say? What's your answer?
I find the young people now, they're all the same. They have no very clear identity. They all follow the fashion, what is in fashion. I see a group of girls going, they all have the, what do you call that thing there in their hand? All of them.
Oh, the vape? The thing they smoke?
No.
Facebook?
Phone?
Yeah,
oh,
I call it this here.
Cell phone?
All have that in hand.
Yes.
Every two minutes, they take it out to see if somebody calls them.
Can I say something? You go into an elevator with them, and instead of looking at the faces, they look at their phones.
Wasn't it newspapers back in the day?
No, we didn't do that. No, yeah, you didn't read in front of someone. It's rude.
If you could give one piece of advice to someone younger than you, what would you say?
Don't follow. Don't be a follower. Be an independent mind. Have your own judgment about things. Otherwise, you're going to become a robot. We used to, when we were young, make sure that we would write a beautiful letter with the right words, right style, etc. This cannot exist anymore, because you only communicate via this thing, which I don't even give it a name, and tap, tap, tip, 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 tip. It's like a telegram. It's a monstrosity.
I have to go by. I've never got your advice.
Just be a good person. If you're a good person, somehow everything works out to be good. That's it.
Thank you.
My advice.
drops it out. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you're definitely going to like this one right here. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I'm Will, and as always, it's a mindset.